Monkeypox outbreak. CDC brushes off airborne transmission. Some experts disagree. Airborne transmission is one of the most deadly transmission routes that can happen. Since we need to breathe, we share the same air and that increases the risk of spreading diseases. Recently, the US CDC dismisses the airborne transmission in the current monkeypox outbreak. However, some experts in the field disagree. Let's start with what's known about monkeypox. According to the US CDC, the monkeypox virus can spread when a person comes into contact with a virus from an infected animal, infected person, or materials contaminated with a virus. The virus can also pass through the placenta from the mother to her fetus. This means pregnant women should be extra careful because the placenta can't stop the virus from making the unborn baby sick. Additionally, the virus may spread via direct contact with body fluids or sores on an infected person or even materials that came into contact with those fluids and sores. Respiratory droplets may also be contaminated, so prolonged face-to-face contact with an infected person is ill-advised, including cuddling and kissing. But the term airborne is not yet included in the description by the CDC. Recently, experts on airborne transmission disagree with the CDC's dismissal of airborne possibility as transmission. The experts agreed that the typical transmission is via direct physical contact, but what they didn't agree with is the agency not fully considering the chances. When COVID-19 emerged, airborne transmission wasn't initially considered until it made sense later on. By that time, you can say it is too late as cases have boomed everywhere. Airborne transmission may not be the dominant route of transmission, nor very efficient, but it could still occur, said Lindsay Marr, an expert on airborne viruses at Virginia Tech per the New York Times. Marr added that the WHO has it right and the CDC's message is misleading. On Friday, CDC officials pushed back the idea of monkeypox spreading via airborne transmission. Meanwhile, the WHO stance is that airborne transmission of monkeypox seems uncommon, yet possible and warrants precautions. Right now, there's nothing wrong with considering airborne transmission since we have that in COVID-19. The pandemic is still on and face masks remain the best defense against it. Although everyone is tired of wearing these things, face masks may be the two-in-one defensive tool in stopping both COVID and monkeypox. The sudden emergence of monkeypox in non-endemic areas may be powered by new mutations. Historical records suggest that people infected with the virus start with flu-like symptoms first, followed by the signature rash. However, some patients in this outbreak developed a rash first, and some didn't even experience either symptom. What do you think about CDC dismissing airborne transmission? Will you wear face masks to protect yourself from monkeypox? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.